Greetings and welcome to Beacon Unitarian Universalist Congregation. To our members, friends, and everyone joining us in our virtual congregation on YouTube today.
Hello, I'm the Reverend Robin Landerman Zucker, minister of this congregation. I am so excited to share this virtual worship service for June 6th, 2021. Broken Hallelujah, the Theology of Leonard Cohen. This multi-layered and multi-dimensional service was created in collaboration with Susannah Martin, the wonderful music director at the Sedona UU Fellowship and members of that congregation, just down the canyon from us here in Flagstaff. I have been so enriched by and grateful for my collaborations with our Sedona UU neighbors this past year, and I believe you will be enriched and inspired by our service today. We're glad you're here and that you've made Beacon Unitarian Universalist Congregation a part of this day in your spiritual life, whether you have been a regular viewer or you're here for the first time. We have been here pretty much every week on YouTube since March 2020, and finally we are planning to begin in-person worship again in our sanctuary at 510 North LaRue Street in Flagstaff on Sunday, June 27th at 10 a.m. with safety measures in place. We hope to see you there so we can reconnect with you or connect with you for the first time. Please bring a mask. I am so proud of our congregation, what we stand for, and how we have stood together and remained connected and committed during the pandemic. Beacon is spiritually open and intentionally inclusive. Whoever you are and whomever you love, you are always welcome here, and we will joyfully marry you here as well. Our members and friends bring many interests, theologies, viewpoints, and life experiences to our door. And here we trust that you will find a common desire for meaningful community and broad spiritual exploration and growth, and for relevant religious dialogue in a framework with very flexible borders. Membership in our congregation is open to anyone who chooses to walk with us in the spirit of love, the search for truth, and the pursuit of justice. Our mission and covenant express these values and our vision of ourselves as a gathered community in the world. Please join me in saying our mission and covenant. The mission of Beacon Unitarian Universalist Congregation is to be a welcoming community that embraces diverse thought and belief and builds a just, peaceful, and compassionate world. Love is the spirit of this church. The quest for truth is its sacrament, and service is its prayer. To dwell together in peace, to seek knowledge and freedom, to serve humanity in kindness. Thus do we covenant. Our service today has a slightly different format, but typically we drop stones in water to share joys and sorrows that are in our community. And I always say at the end of that time, let us remember that there are many joys and sorrows that remain unspoken, because they are either too tender or too private to share. And may we remember that everyone is fighting their own private battle. We know not what it is, but because we're human, we know it to be true. And Leonard Cohen knew it to be true and explored it deeply in his work. So let us be kind, compassionate, flexible, and forgiving with one another. And my hope stone that has taken us through this year, well, 15 months actually, let us hold on to hope for ourselves, for our family and friends, for our congregations and communities, for our cities and towns, our country, our world, and our planet. And now, Broken Hallelujah, the Theology of Leonard Cohen.
Thank you. secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
On the path of loneliness, I came to the place of song and tarried there for half my life. Now I leave my guitar and my keyboards, my companions, and I stumble out again on the path of loneliness. I am old, but I have no regrets, not one. Even though I am angry and alone and filled with fear and desire, bend down to me from your mist and vines, O High One, long-fingered and deep-seeing. Bend down to this sack of bones and press your lips to the light of my heart.
We call this light before us in hope that we may always remain a strong community. May we know we are loved. May we share the love we have, and may we be the love we wish to see.
Broken Hallelujah, The Theology of Leonard Cohen. Even though Leonard Cohen never identified as a Unitarian Universalist, many of us UUs identify deeply and in an almost visceral way with him and his work. Cohen, who died in 2018, was a postmodern hyphenate like many UUs. He was a Jewish, Buddhist, Hindu, Jesus-loving seeker and artist. Yet this unparalleled poet at his core was unabashedly Jewish, so much so that former chief rabbi of the United Kingdom, Lord Sacks, devoted a whole homily to Cohen's final album, You Want It Darker, pointing out its deep roots in the Hebrew Bible, the rabbinical traditions of Midrash, and Jewish liturgy itself. Yet Cohen's Judaism, according to scholar Philip Roseman, was no less broken than his Christianity. Both for him were mythologies. What resonated for Cohen, as his lyrics show us, is that Christ, unlike the God of the Hebrew Bible, submitted himself to the pain of the world, and this rendered him deeply attractive to Leonard Cohen. We can detect this inspirational modeling in Cohen's own personal attempt to submit himself and his listeners to the pain and the joy of existence, as he minds theology and spirituality and how they reside in a tense matrix with secularism in the human realm. All of the selections that Susannah and I have chosen for today's service quiver to their core with this central project for Cohen. How does God, or what we consider sacred, walk with us or abandon us? In what ways do we forsake the divine in a modern world by killing the flame? How do we steer past the ruins of faith and society? What is love, sacred and human? And can we abide in hope, believing that there is a crack in everything, that place where the light gets in? Is there enough hope in the possibilities of a human life to sing a cold and broken hallelujah to the last? If we begin with the song Hallelujah, our starting point is Cohen's tribal roots in Judaism. Hallelujah is a rich and ancient Hebrew word of prayer used to express gratitude and praise for the Lord. The story arc of the song, in fact, traces elements of the biblical story of King David and his secret chord, his love affair with Bathsheba, you saw her bathing on the roof, with further allusions to Samson and Delilah. She broke your throne and cut your hair. Cohen reveals his keen understanding of biblical structure with the concluding line of this verse, and from his lips she drew a hallelujah, a nod to the praise that typically follows lamentations in the Psalms that were written by David. Cohen explains that he was trying to get at the way religion, intimacy, and music connect, and how they can each be healing activities worthy of praise. Over the years, Cohen himself tried to understand what motivated him to write this meaningful and now very famous song in 1984. And here are some of his quotes on the subject. I wanted to write something in the tradition of the Hallelujah chorus, but from a different point of view. I had a desire to affirm my own faith in life, not in some formal religious way, but with enthusiasm, with emotion. He wrote, there is a religious hallelujah, but there are many other ones. When one looks at the world and his proper life, There is only one thing to say, even if it is a cold and broken hallelujah. Cohen exposes his Buddhist leanings in adding, it is to praise the energy that manifests both good and evil. Cohen's own interpretation of hallelujah is resonant of a frequent humanist theme at the core of Unitarian Universalism and in many of my sermons also. Namely, how to sing a cold and broken hallelujah through the inevitable joy and sorrow, shadow and light of a human journey, without leaning into traditional religious expectations, doctrines, formulas, or salvations. Cohen lifts this up when he tells a journalist that, look, I don't understand anything at all. Hallelujah. That's the moment that we live fully as human beings. Hallelujah. It's a very invigorating word to sing just to affirm our little journey here. Cohen offers a more upbeat reprise of his beloved song Anthem, written in 1992. In the chorus, Cohen acknowledges this perfectly imperfect world and human life, the suffering, the shadow, the holy wars fought and the doves who will be caught. He asks us to be awake and in that wokeness to keep faith. It is certainly a song as we come out of this pandemic year.
Perfect.
ring the bells that still can ring. Forget your perfect offering. There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in. Where is the crack for you? Where might the light get in? To your joy, to your sorrow, to your authentic life. Hallelujah. Light, generally speaking, can be hard to find in Cohen's later work, especially in his two spoken word pieces, Steer Your Way and You Want It Darker, both written in 2016. The pieces are brutally honest and stunningly vivid in their bleakness about our current culture and the state of humankind. Yet Cohen is admonishing us not to lay down and die or submit to the decay, but to steer our way, steer your way past the ruins of the altar and the mall. The scholar Philip Roseman notes that the poem immediately opens on a disenchanted note, introducing us to a landscape of ruins, but the altar and the mall, both the altar and the mall, have fallen into decay. The symbolism is not hard to read. The altar serves as the center of divine worship, while the mall is the place where modern man worships consumption together with the money that is necessary to indulge in it. God and mammon are old enemies. One may recall the passage in Luke where Jesus declares, "No servant can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon." The fullness of what God is meant to offer us is mirrored by the empty promise of material consumption and the belief that we can buy anything, perhaps even love, perhaps even hope, perhaps even faith, perhaps even a cure for a disease. Later in the poem, Cohen lifts up this dichotomy in the lines, "As he died to make men holy, let us die to make things cheap, and say the mea culpa which we gradually forgot."
Steer your way past the ruins of the altar and the mall. Steer your way through the fables of creation and the fall. Steer your way past the palaces that rise above the rock, year by year, month by month, day by day, thought by thought. Steer your heart past the truth you believed in yesterday, such as fundamental goodness and the wisdom of the way. Steer your heart, precious heart, past the women whom you've bought, year by year, month by month, day by day, thought by thought. Your path through the pain that's far more real than you, that smashed the cosmic model, that blinded every view. Oh, and please don't make me go there. Though it be a god or not, year by year, month by month, day. Throw back out. They whisper still the ancient stories, the blooming mountains weep as they died to make men holy. Let us die to make things cheap and say the mea culpa, which you've probably forgot. Year by year, month by month, day by day. Never equal to the task. Who knows he's been convicted? Who knows he will be shot? Year by year, month by month, day by day. The mountains weep as he died to make men holy. Let us die to make things cheap and say the mea culpa, which you gradually forgot. Year by year, month by month, day by day. Thought by
Roseman, in his paper, Leonard Cohen, Philosopher, pursues this idea further. He writes, "The world in Steer Your Way has been disenchanted as God is pushed to the edge. We no longer pray for a good harvest, but invest in fertilizers and pesticides. We do not hope for a better life in the hereafter, but strive to make this life pleasant." The palaces that rise above the rod in the poem are monuments to the decadent, superficial culture that does not even grasp its own groundlessness. The blunted mountains weeping represent environmental degradation. "This is why God is dead," says Roseman. "We ourselves have killed him," or killed the flame, as Cohen puts it in his poem called "You Want It Darker." To save ourselves, returning to the old world of traditional religions is not an option. Cohen doesn't even desire that anymore, and he doesn't desire it any more than we do, although he grieves what has been lost with these touchstones. He writes, referencing Genesis, "Steer your way through the fables of creation and the fall." Steering our way is not a one-time deal either. It requires almost monastic devotion, year by year, month by month, thought by thought, as Cohen's refrain reminds us. The stanza that speaks deeply to me is the second one. "Steer your heart past the truth that you believed in yesterday, such as fundamental goodness and the wisdom of the way." In this verse, I hear Cohen lifting up a fundamental religious belief that God is fundamentally good. This is surely what distinguished early Unitarians from their Calvinist brethren who preached about original sin and inherent deprivation and depravity. And in the well-loved song, Suzanne, Cohen laments a loss of Christian faith in these lines: forsaken, almost human, he sank beneath your wisdom like a stone. Cohen, as a Jew, cannot overlook the evil in history that has been personal for him, but he can continue to have an examined and questioning faith in "You Want It Darker." These lines allude to the Holocaust, in which millions died, forsaken, one might argue, by their God. Where was the fundamental goodness? The poem reads, "They're lining up the prisoners and the guards are taking aim. I struggled with some demons. They were middle class and tame. I didn't know I had permission to murder and to maim. You want it darker. We kill the flame." And in the next stanza, "A million candles burning for the love that never came. You want it darker. We killed the flame." These verses are searing, and they call out for comfort. In this vein, the introduction of the heart in that second stanza of Steer Your Way struck me as so poignant and significant. The heart is the universal symbol of affection and love, themes that Cohen explores in many of his works. In Suzanne, for example, human and divine love are intertwined, mirroring each other.
Suzanne takes you down to her place near the river. You can hear the boats go by. You can spend the night beside her. And you know that she's half crazy, but that's why you want to be there. And she feeds you tea and oranges that come all the way from China. And just when tell her that you have no love to give her, then she gets you in a wavelength, and she lets the river answer that you've always been her lover. And you want to travel with her, and you want to travel blind, and you think maybe you'll trust her, for she's touched your perfect body with her mind. And Jesus was a sailor when he walked upon the water, and he spent a long time watching from his lonely wooden tower. And when he knew for certain only drowning men could see him, he said, "All men will be sailors then, until the sea shall free them." But he himself was broken long before the sky would open. Forsaken, almost human, he sank beneath your wisdom like a stone. Travel with him, and you want to travel blind, and you know that you can trust him, for he's touched your perfect body with his mind. Now Suzanne takes you down, and she leads you to the river. She was wearing rags and feathers from Salvation Army counters, and the sun pours down like honey on Our Lady of the Harbor, and she'll show you where to look among the garbage and the flowers. There are heroes in the seaweed. There are children in the morning. They are leaning out for love, and they will lean that way forever while Suzanne holds the mirror. And you want to travel with her, and you want to travel blind, and you think maybe you'll trust her, for you've touched her perfect body with your mind.
I had never considered before, as Roseman points out, that as it is situated between the brain and the stomach, the heart symbolizes the place in between reason and desire, where human beings make fundamental decisions regarding the direction of their lives. Putting one's heart into the task means really taking it seriously with passion and devotion. One can be open-hearted, or one's heart can be bent back into itself, according to a famous expression attributed to the theologian Augustine. One can be heartless, and another can be heartful. Which way will we steer? Which way will you steer? Day by day, month by month, thought by thought, heartbeat by heartbeat. The way of the open heart is also an important Buddhist concept that Cohen would have been intimately familiar with as a practitioner of meditation and a student of Buddhist thought, including the Heart Sutra, which encourages an enlightened acceptance of impermanence. Cohen takes us deeper into feeling as his message of despair becomes even more persistent and insistent. Steer your way through the pain that is far more real than you, that smashed the cosmic model, that blinded every view. Pain is not abstract here, and we have all experienced it. It cuts to the bone. It is far more real than you, or the you here referring to God. Notice that he admonishes us to steer through the pain, not past it. Not away from it. We cannot avoid pain, cannot master it. We can only go through the fire. And then the poet's voice stands for us when we are in our darkest place, pleading, and please don't make me go there. But we do go there in a fully human life, not past the pain, but through it. As Cohen wrote in one of his earliest works, Beautiful Loser, in 1966, and his words still ring so truly today, please make me empty. If I am empty, then I can receive and I will not be alone. Speaking to the divine in some form, Cohen tells us in Hallelujah, I used to live alone before I knew you. And you want it darker? We can detect Cohen lifting up Christ alone and forsaken on the cross and making more allusions to genocide, Holocaust, and the void left by an absent God.
Thank you.
glory, then mine must be the shame. You want it darker. We kill the flame.
Magnified, sanctified be thy holy name, vilified, crucified in the human frame, a million candles burning for the love that never came. You want it darker, we kill the flame. Yet one could also argue that as Cohen prepared for death, he was engaging in the long-standing Jewish tradition of confronting God, putting him on trial, and asking him, you want it darker, God? You've got it. Look around. We kill the flame, and we can keep it up. Is he asking the Jewish God to show himself? Or is he channeling Dharma about craving, suffering, and impermanence, and the fine line between good and evil? In the end, it will be our calling to fuel the flame of faith, tend the flame of goodness, and quench the flame of evil. Leonard Cohen is a wonderful model, authentic and prophetic, asking all the important existential questions. And like all prophets, He hears the call and answers, Hineni, Hineni, here I am. It is what all Hebrew prophets answer after three attempts at calling them into service, the service of prophethood. Despite the darkness of these later works, Cohen is not a fatalist. So we wonder, what is he ready for? Death? Despair? Joy? Ready to love? To grapple with his shadow and ours? Ready for every cold and broken and warm and beautiful thing? What about us? What are we ready for? Particularly after months of lockdown and quarantine. This planet and those who inhabit it alongside us, can we steer our way and save it, O precious hearts? In our brokenness and in our wholeness, may we praise it all and sing, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Hallelujah. Blessed be, blessed we, and amen. Each week in our service, whether we're here in our actual sanctuary or here in our virtual YouTube sanctuary, we take an offering to support Beacon, its staff, its programs, its buildings, and its community partners. There are two ways for you to donate to Beacon today. You can go to our website, www.beaconuu.com, find the donate button, and make a secure online donation through the Vanco application. If you use this method, we ask that you use a bank account rather than a debit or credit card to save us some fees, and there will be more for us that way, and to support Beacon as we move forward and into the fall as we gather together again in community. Or you could send us a check to 510 North LaRue Street, Flagstaff, Arizona, 86001, and please write offering in the note. Either way, we are so grateful for your generosity and support, especially during this unique and transitional time.
The fragrance of those promises you never dared to vow, the splendor that you carry, the cross you left behind. Come healing of the body, come healing of the mind, and let the heavens hear it, the penitential hymn. Come healing of the spirit, in arbitrary space, and none of us deserving of the cruelty or the grace. Oh, solitude of longing, where love has been confined, come healing of the body, come say the darkness yielding that tore the light apart. Come healing of the reason, come healing of the heart. Troubleness concealing an undivided love, the heart beneath is teaching to the broken heart above. And let the heavens falter, let all the earth proclaim, come healing of the altar, come healing of the name. To lift the little bud, oh, longing of the outraged to purify the blood, and let the heavens hear it, the penitential hymn, come healing of the spirit, come healing of the land. Oh, let the heavens hear it, the penitential hymn, come healing.
We extinguish the chalice here that it might glow gently in our hearts. May it light your path as you leave this space. May it guide your way until we are together again.
Hallelujah is a dangerous word, especially in the mouths of the creatively maladjusted. Hallelujah is a dangerous word, for it comes always with an exclamation point. Hallelujah is a dangerous word, for it is the sign of a people claiming and exclaiming their sacred worth and praising that which brought them into being. Hallelujah is a dangerous word for another reason, my friends, and that's because it takes an extra pointed kind of breath. And breath is life. And life, when it's animated, is perhaps a bit dangerous. Breath. Breathing together, singing together, boldness and courage rising. Hallelujah!
And finally, at the end of our service, we come together when we're here in the sanctuary and will be again. We stand in a circle and we hold hands and we tangibly feel the connection, the love, and the strength of this community. So I invite you to imagine yourself reaching out and holding the hands of others, known and unknown, and feeling the warmth, feeling the strength, feeling the connection. Because whether we've been apart or whether we are together, we are Beacon, always connected. Blessed be, blessed we, and amen.